I've seen enough on Gerald Battistoni. I believe that he should be charged and put in front of a jury and let a jury decide whether he's innocent or guilty. I believe that the police are hiding, covering up his crimes because it's too embarrassing for them. And that's just in the Molly Bish murder. Now, let's look at the way Gerald Battistoni was used in my case. I'm thinking here that Molly Bish is a drug war victim, because you can be a victim of the drug war and never touch a drug. I think that Molly Bish is a drug war victim because it's looking to me like Gerald Battistoni, a confidential informant in the drug war, murdered her. An affidavit is a sworn statement by a police officer. Usually it's true. And what they do is they give it to a judge so they can get a warrant. Well, in this case, this affidavit has me selling marijuana from my home to a confidential informant on 225.03, on 314.03, and 48 hours prior to the raid is what the third says. Now, on these dates, I was in the hospital. Do I look like I'm ready to sell pot? I'm really not. I've got all the hospital documentation here. Police, halfway through the raid, stopped searching when my daughter got a call to me, and they realized I was actually in the hospital. She gave them the phone. They said, "Who is this?" I said, "This is Captain Joint," and they hung up. At that point, they left the house, half of it unsearched. I was never charged with anything, even though in this newspaper article, which was done from a press release from Chief Gleason, stated that I was arrested for possession with intent to sell, possession of glass pipes, possession with intent to sell drug paraphernalia. Scott E. Haley not only is guilty of perjury on an affidavit to get a warrant, he's also guilty of manufacturing false evidence and presenting it to the court. The courts would not accept it, and they threw it out. Chief Kevin P. Gleason was made chief of police in the year 2000. He was thrown off for an OUI. Okay? So they made him chief of police of Holland, Mass. His first act as chief of police was to come in and raid me. And they're looking at him for missing drugs and missing money, and he's the only one with a key, and he won't take a lie detector test. He finally was pulled up in front of a judge. They rolled all his crimes into what they called a larceny plea, and he was sentenced 2 years in jail with 3 years probation. And he served 3 months and got out. Jill Battistoni's confidential informant number 62 was illegally attached to an affidavit that was used to get a warrant to do a SWAT raid on a home. The two officers involved would have perjured themselves. If these two officers are arrested and convicted for the crimes of perjury and for the use of this confidential informant, would force Massachusetts to open up over 500 drug cases. In the case of the raid on my home, how Gerald Battistoni was used, the perjury on the police, these two cops will never be arrested, because it's way too expensive for Massachusetts to open up 500 drug cases. We got two depositions from Special Agent Scott E. Haley and from Chief Kevin P. Gleason. In these two depositions, these officers detail how Gerald Battistoni walked into my home 3 times, bought marijuana from me 3 times from my home while I was documented in the hospital. You know, if this guy had been sent into my home, I might be missing a child. It took me years to find out who he was. His information was finally given to me by a private detective, Dan Malley, from Worcester, Mass. The detective asked me to sit on that for a while because there was more involved. Well, he's now in jail doing 10 to 12 years for serial child rape. And right after he was arrested for the serial child rape, Detective Dan Mallory exposed him as a suspect in the Molly Bish murder, where Gerald Battistoni was documented buying drugs for the police. So the wife says that he was driving a white car, just like Molly Bish's mother described to the police. When the police sketches came out, he shaved his mustache because he looked so much like the police sketches, and he wouldn't go out. He had her act out weird, sick sex fantasies with him, rape fantasies, wearing girls' underwear, little girls' underwear, and she didn't know where he got them. He's been identified as a potential suspect, and at the time that he was identified, he allegedly tried to cut his throat in jail with a broken light bulb and was put into the mental health system. Nobody's really heard much of him since, not in the papers anyway. I have hard copy that this police officer, still a police officer, perjured himself, lied, and created false evidence. Should this guy be on the force? I don't think so. Should Gleason be charged with the crimes against my family? I think so. Is Molly Bish a drug war victim? It looks like it. What are you gonna do?